Hello students, today's topic is built up of total cost. We'll start with the diagram. Total cost is divided into three major parts. The first part is material. Now as you know, this is the topic of cost accounting. So material is very important because we are dealing with production. So material can further be divided into two parts. One would be direct material and other would be indirect material. When I say direct material, the material which is required for production. That means without direct material, the production cannot be done. When I come to indirect material, the other supplements, which can be with the oil of the machine and any other thing. The next part would be labor. Labor is very important. Production cannot be done without the help of the labor. The first part in labor is again direct, and the second part is indirect. First, I talk about direct labors. When I talk about direct labors, the labor which is actually going to convert the raw materials into finished goods. When I talk about indirect labor, the labor which will help you to supply those finished goods. It can be related with sales, it can be related with distribution. We'll go to the third one, and those are expenses. When I talk about expenses, expenses will again be divided into two parts. First would be direct and other one would be indirect. Direct expenses are those expenses which are related with the production, again including the carrier charges, any type of tax, any liability which they have to pay directly to bring that raw material or the labors. And indirect expenses will be related with factory, sales and distribution, and office and administration. So indirect will be further divided into three parts. First would be your factory cost. Second would be your office cost, and the last one would be your selling and distribution cost. Factory cost will include everything, including your maintenance, any kind of any kind of machine related charges, any such thing. Office cost will include the cost of all your office expenses, including the furnitures, the salary of the person who works in the office. And selling and distribution is very important, starting from the delivery event to the advertisement. Everything will be included into the selling cost. Now let's just see how to calculate the total cost. We'll take examples. Like suppose our selling cost is 500, then our office cost is again 500, and our factory cost is 1000. So the total becomes 2000 rupees for the indirect expenses. When I go with the direct, we'll take it as 1000. The club of direct and indirect will make the expenses, which comes to 3000 rupees. Then we'll take example for labor. Suppose the labor is 1000, the direct labor, and the indirect labor is also 1000. So the club will become 2000 over here. And we'll go to the materials. If the indirect material is 1000 and the direct material is again 1000, the club will again become 2000. Now to calculate the total cost, we will add the three. So the total will become 7000. This is how we actually calculate the total cost. And when it comes to the selling price, in the total cost amount, you're going to add the profit. Now the question is how to add the profit. You can add profit in two ways. Either you can take out the percentage of the sales, or you can take out the percentage of the total cost. So total cost plus profit will actually help you to determine your selling price, and this selling price can be calculated by dividing it by the number of units. So today we will conclude this by saying that total cost is a merger of three things, that is material, labor and expenses, and the total of three when added with profit will give you selling price. Thank you.